a lot happened in this one. A lot of change, which is the theme of this movie. Changes. Is it a necessity to have changes? Or is it something that you want? It's time to get back behind the register and count every penny and dime. I didn't really expect that much to happen in Clerks 2. This one took things a step further with its story, characters, and comedy. This is part 7 of my Viewaskew retrospective.
I got a fire at the quick stop. Yeah.
Clerks 2 takes place 12 years after the original, with Dante and Randall now being in their 30s. After the quick stop is burnt down, the boys get jobs at movies, and at the start of this movie's one-year time skip, Dante is entering his final day on duty. Along with Dante and Randall slacking and conversating at their job, Jay and Silent Bob return from rehab. They still act the same, they're just off drugs now. They still provide some scene-stealing moments.
Get the fuck out!
There's also new characters like Becky, Elias, and Emma joining the cast. Becky is used to Randall's antics and sometimes has a comeback to his wisecracks. She's also a non-believer in marriage. Her and Dante have a close personal relationship, one they can't deny. Elias is pretty much oblivious and innocent, a bit of a bumbling employee who Randall picks on. Think of Gen Xers working with millennials. Add those two things together, and it's something you don't want happening in the workplace. Emma is Dante's fiance. She's the one that's giving Dante the potential to live the life he always wanted. For the second time, he's torn between two things. Which is the right choice? Which is the one he really wants? Out of the three new characters introduced, they all bring something to the table and are developed as characters. Dante and Randall get further development and are faced with anxieties of actual change and being in their 30s. Things have been the same for them for a decade, and to see things change can be a scary thing. The writing for Clerks 2 takes Kevin Smith back to his roots, and he's at his best when writing these characters. The jokes in the movie take it a step further than in the first movie. Also, Dante and Randall get great character development. Now that it's in a fast food setting, much like Quick Stop and video store employees that got justice, fast food employees can finally get their due. Did they do that? Not really. Movies was more of a backdrop, and less focus was given to how much it sucks working at fast food. I like that Rosario Dawson was added to the cast. She brought it for this role. And really, that's one thing I admire about this actress. No matter what material she's given, she gives it her all. She has a standout performance along with Brian O'Halloran, Jeff Anderson, and Jason Mewes. In particular, that one scene near the end. For those who've seen this movie, you know which scene I'm talking about. It's a scene that deserves accolades. Performances are all around good. The soundtrack is similar to Jay and Silent Bob Strikes Back. Numerous genres from different decades. This time around, it's just passable. There's a lot to like about this movie. However, with pros comes cons. There's missed opportunities here and there involving movies and exploring what sucks about fast food jobs. And shockingly, the dialogue delivery is sometimes a little iffy. And the pacing is just a little off at times. Now, the climax is definitely noteworthy for being one of the most exciting climaxes in a non-action movie. There, a lot happened in the last 35 to 40 minutes of this movie's climax, And I just have to say, a lot of character development, a lot of drama, a lot of fantastic dialogue and character introspectives. It's just some of Kevin Smith's best work caught on camera. Overall, I will give Clerks 2 a recommendation. It's a pretty good sequel, and I wonder why some people don't like it. As of right now, I need Clerks 3 ASAP to conclude Dante and Randall's story. Ben Affleck, get in touch with Kevin Smith already. Jeff Anderson, do Clerks 3, it's just one more movie. I need a conclusion. I feel with these movies that people overlook the message of them and just see them as stoner comedies. Which they are, there's no changing that. But with the Viewaskew movies, there's something to take and learn from each of them. Yes, that includes you, Mallrats. These movies are some of the best in their categories, and two, arguably three in particular, will be talked about for years. Clerks, Chasing Amy, and possibly Dogma. Which is the best Viewaskew movie? Well, for me, it's a tie between Clerks and Chasing Amy. Clerks, because I relate to the story, coming in on your day off to a job that you utterly can't stand and customers you don't want around. Any young adult can relate to this. Then there's Chasing Amy, which made me give a damn about a romance. It's easily Kevin Smith's best written film, and overall, the movie's just pretty good. When it came time to choose which is the best, I couldn't decide between these two, so I chose a tie. Which now just leaves one question. Which one do you think is the best one? Not your personal favorite, what do you think is the best overall Viewaskew movie? For now, I wait on any news on the Jay and Silent Bob reboot. This has been my Viewaskew retrospective, and if you've been here since part one, I'd just like to say thank you for sticking around. Now I leave you with this. I'm Lino Mares of the MMCA Productions crew, and I'll see you next time.
Who cares? That guy's an asshole. Everybody that comes in here is way too uptight. This job would be great if it wasn't for the fucking customers.
Jesus, I'm gonna hear from the boss tomorrow.
Oh, would you loosen up?
Tuesday? You gotta be fucking kidding me. I got a hockey game at 2 and the steel shutters are jammed closed and he's in Vermont? I'm not even supposed to be here today.
It's true, man. You sit there and blame Blake for dealing you a cruddy hand, never once accepting responsibility for the way your situation is.
What responsibility?
All right, if you hate this job and the people and the fact that you have to come in on your day off, then why don't you quit?
Like it's that easy.
It is. You just up and quit. There's other jobs.
Like your life's any better.
Hey, I'm satisfied with my situation for now. You don't hear me complaining. You, on the other hand, have been bitching all day.
That kid is back on the escalator again.
Leave it alone.
Come, son of Jarrell. Kneel before Zod.
Snitchy boochies.
Oh my god. Holy shit! Aren't you? Oh, Stanley.
It's about a guy who comes to this club. High tech, he finds out. Ready for this? This girl is gay. Well, because it's captured the moment. It'll be a constant reminder, not just of tonight, but of our introduction, the building of our friendship. Everything. Make no mistake about it, my
friend. I pushed her away. So I spent every day since then chasing her.
You know, here's what I don't get about you. You know for a fact that there is a God. You've been in his presence. He's spoken to you personally.
You are Bethany Sloane. No one can take that away from you, not even God. All this means is a redefinition of that identity.
I can't believe this shit. 5 hours and not a single ride. Every day people hitch to Hollywood to stop studios from making films about them. But when you and me try, it's like we're trapped in a fucking cartoon.
Oh! The party's across the street featuring the greatest band in the world!
forced into time!
Lord did something with it. He smited that hellhole.
Listen to you. You mean to tell me you don't miss that place at all?
God, no. You?
Of course not.
People be like, there he goes. Homeboy fucked a Martian once.
And what's that? You obviously have such a great handle on your life. Tell me what you would do if you were in my position. Or even what you'd do in your own position. Swing that judgmental pendulum back the other way and tell me how you'd solve all your problems, asshole. What the fuck would the great Randall Graves do if he were half the master of his destiny that I'm supposed to be?
I'd buy the Quick Stop and reopen it myself.